It is a great pleasure for me to be here to declare open this second international conference on lead poisoning associated with artisanal gold mining in Nigeria. May I also join in welcoming experts from various parts of the world who are here to assist us in thinking through the solutions to what is a serious public health problem, especially in Zamfara and Niger States of Nigeria. I'm aware that the first international conference on lead poisoning is a joint effort of the Federal Ministry of Health and Médecins and Frontières, and that was held in Abuja here in May 2012. The 2012 conference mostly covered technical aspects of environmental management and the treatment of poisoned children. But today's event has been organized by the Ministry of Mines and Skill Development in collaboration with Médecins Sans Frontières, and it will provide a platform for key national, regional, and international stakeholders to come together to develop a multi-sector, interdisciplinary, and pragmatic national strategy for forestalling future outbreaks of lead poisoning, especially those associated with artisanal gold mining, and to prevent the recontamination of previously remediated sites. While the federal government has pursued a national gold purchase scheme, as well as the development of a national gold policy, gold mining in Nigeria, as we've heard repeatedly, is currently dominated by artisanal miners using rudimentary mining methods and crude processing techniques. The obvious consequence is the exposure of miners, the environment, and local communities to serious danger. In areas where gold ores contain high concentration of heavy metals like lead, exposure to the dust released from these metals as a result of the crude processing techniques leads to serious health consequences, not just for the persons directly involved in the mining, but also for all of the neighboring areas and communities. Children, of course, are the ones most at risk of death and disability. Many will recall the outbreak of lead poisoning that occurred in Zamfara State, and that has also been repeated many times today. In 2010, as a result of the processing of lead-rich gold ores by artisanal gold miners in residential compounds and village squares, surveys carried out in the affected villages at that time showed that more than 17,000 people were severely exposed, and an estimated 400 to 500 children lost their lives due to acute lead poisoning. The combined efforts of various international agencies, including the Médecins Sans Frontières, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the World Health Organization, Terra Graphics International Foundation, and the governments of Zamfara State and the federal government, helped to bring that tragic episode under control. Regrettably, 5 years after the Zamfara outbreak, another outbreak of severe lead poisoning was reported in April 2015. In 2 villages in Niger State. As with the outbreak in Zamfara State, this new outbreak was precipitated by environmental lead contamination from artisanal gold mining activities. Nearly 30 children died from severe lead toxicity, and many more were poisoned. Again, the Médecins Sans Frontières with local authorities commenced chelation treatment shortly after environmental remediation was completed by the federal government in September 2016. To date, nearly 7,200 children in Zamfara and Niger State respectively have received chelation treatment. I'm informed that this is the largest group of children under 5 years of age with severe lead intoxication reported anywhere. Unfortunately, treatment does not reverse the debilitating effects of lead poisoning. It only accelerates the rate at which the body expels the lead in order to prevent further damage or death. So that the thousands of children who did not die of lead poisoning in Zamfara and Niger States may therefore have to live with cognitive and other disabilities. Many of these children may never attain their full potential as productive citizens. We must start by admitting that the current joint efforts to tackle lead poisoning in artisanal gold mining have not been adequate. What better evidence do we have for that than the fact that the Niger State outbreak happened 5 years after we thought we had contained that problem? Indications of recontamination in previously remediated sites in Zamfara compel us to rethink and refocus our commitment and strategy to protecting our vulnerable children and communities at large. As Nigeria traverses, and I quote, the road to shared mining prosperity, we must ensure that we do not do it in a way that harms our health or our environment. Those who say that the option is death by poisoning rather than poverty offer a cynical false choice. Artisanal mining and the life to enjoy the wealth from it is possible if we put in place the proper preventive measures and provide the right equipment. No country should have to pay for its economic prosperity and development with the lives and well-being of its people. I'm confident that this conference. I'm confident that this conference will produce a federally coordinated prevention plan that leverages all the lessons learned so far and bring local, state, and federal authorities, as well as civil society and the corporates, into alignment. We must avoid working in silence and expect to resolve the problems, especially because these problems cut across sectors and disciplines. I strongly believe that a carefully thought out and comprehensive national plan that focuses on populations and communities most vulnerable to lead poisoning associated with artisanal gold mining will yield the desired results. Let me commend the efforts of the Ministry of Mines and Solid Minerals, Médecins Sans Frontières, and other ministries and actors in convening this critical summit and this critical search for optimal ways of preventing lead poisoning, especially of children. Permit me to especially commend the innovative leadership and clear sense of purpose of the Honourable Minister of Mines and Steel, the Honourable Abubakar and members of his team. And I also want to commend the great work that has been done by our partners, the Médecins Sans Frontières, and all the civil society groups that have worked so closely with us to resolve these problems. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is now my very special privilege and pleasure to declare the second international conference on lead poisoning open. Thank you and God bless you.